President, corporate and board members of ISF, distinguished gathering, friends from media, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed my pleasure to be with you. That is industry staffing conference here. And as on today, the focus is on employment in the age of productivity. As already the President has touched most of the issues which require to be addressed, and mainly is about the jobs, big question mark. Yes, definitely any parent, but anyway I can say every parent wants that their children should go to school, get good formal education, and after getting education they should get decent job. And even the person from the weakest who is not able to earn even two times meals also wants that his children should go to the best school and then they should get the best job. And naturally, as in our country, we have 45 crore, means 450 million approximately as the workforce with us. In that 450 million, we have 93% in the informal sector, means we call them as unorganized workers. As on today, unorganized workers, really there is a big question mark for them, for their social security, for their decent wages, for their security of the job. So they have all types of problems. Then we come to the formal sector, who are in the organized sector, they get everything. They get the social security, they get the minimum wages, they get the security of the job, everything they get. But in addition to that, what we have 450 million, as already President pointed out, 10 to 12 million every year we get in addition to that. So naturally to provide job to each and every person is a difficult task, and as a Ministry of Labour, we are for them. We want that each and every person should get decent job, security of the job, and social security at the same time. So and at the same time, dignity for the labor is required. So as the present government has taken up the many programs, and particularly like Make in India, Digital India, plus Skill India, and in the Ministry of Skill, lot of programs have been taken up so that they give the maximum skill to the unorganized sector people, and subsequently they can be given the jobs. So a person who is coming, who is taking any skill program, and even any person who has taken any degree, then what we are going for a National Career Service Portal. A person can register on that National Career Service Portal, and once he registers, then there are already employers are also registered on that. And once they are registered, then the counseling can, he can take up the counseling also. He can see the even input, career input, input on the portal, and accordingly he can be selected for a job. As on today, on National Career Service Portal, we have approximately 4.25 crore people who have already registered on this National Career Service Portal. And 25 lakh jobs have been already, vacancies have been notified on this career service portal. But it is difficult to assess how many have actually they have been given, though they have been offered, but have they joined or not. As it was already pointed out, the problem with the in India is there is not a crisis for job. Jobs are there, employment is there. But a person wants again a job of, he is not able to get as per his what he expects. Actually, that now in India, the problem is the maximum persons, they want a government job because lot of social security, lot of social status and all that. But in other sectors also jobs are available. But a person again, he tries for a government job. If he does not get, then he tries something else. Suppose if I want a good driver as on today, very difficult to get a good driver, and means who can come regularly and all that. So the jobs are there, but only thing is that a person who wants a job, he is not able to adjust, he gets settled somewhere else actually. So that problem is coming, but anyhow, we hope that with the coming days, things will settle down in a better way. Now we come down for the what initiatives we have taken up in our ministry, because naturally, if the labor has to be given a social security and also for the dignity for the labor, then we have to see that he should this whatever the labor acts we are having should be implemented properly. As on today, we have 44 acts with us, and now why? Because 44 acts, we are subsuming all these acts into four codes. We are coming up with the four codes. One is wage code, second is the IR code, third is social security code, fourth is working condition code. As I have already told, three things a person need. One is the minimum wages a person should get, second thing is the security for the job, third is the social security. So for getting a minimum wage, we have a wage code. So this wage code is almost now ready. We have already introduced in the parliament, and it will be now coming up at any in the next session. It may be through actually. IR code is also now all stakeholders have given their views, and it will be introduced in the next session for the parliament. Then social security code is also social security code and working code. We have already called for the comments from all the stakeholders, and it is ready. It is available on our website also. So in the coming sessions, these codes will be through. Now, to get the minimum wages also, we have revised the minimum wages. In the last year, we have asked to increase the wages 42%. So the government has increased the wages to 42%. And with the increase of the wages, a person can now have a decent life. He will get minimum 300 rupees per day. That too unskilled. If he's a semi-skilled or a skilled, he will get little bit more also. Then in addition to that, we have revised the Payment of Wages Act also, so that the wages should be paid in time by all companies, and if the wages are not paid in time, then as you all know, the action may be taken. And in addition to that, we have told that the wages should be paid. If required, it can be paid through their accounts also. So we are moving means if you are paying the amount through the accounts, naturally we are moving from informal sector to a formal sector. And in addition to that, we have even amended our Employees Compensation Act. So in case if any company is not violating these acts, then definitely under Employees Compensation Act, action can be taken. Then Gratuity Act also was amended. Gratuity Act, now it has been, as per the Gratuity Act, earlier it was 10 lakh rupees per person, now it has been increased to 20 lakh rupees. Then we have done, even for the women also, as we know, most 50% and above are the women, and particularly in informal sector. So we have asked that in the maternity benefit, under Maternity Benefit Act, from 12 months to 26 months, a woman who is pregnant should get minimum 26 weeks leave. It will be paid holidays. And then for the child labor also, we told no child should be allowed to work. Below 14 years, it is absolutely totally banned on child labor actually. And between 14 to 18, they should not work. The children should not work in a hazardous process or hazardous industries where there is they are dealing with the hazardous material actually. Then we have, as already pointed out in the EPFO, we have gone for the universal account number. Already around 13 crore people have taken up that universal account number. This universal account number is a portable account. Means a person, if he is working in Odisha and if he is moving from Odisha to Hyderabad or to Bombay, the same account number can work. At the same time, even for the companies also, we have a LIN actually. This is labor identification. So companies should also, establishment should also take the LIN number. Employees should take the universal account number. All these are the portable, so that it will be a unique number, and at any point of time he can use that number and can get his whatever payments and other things can be settled. And in the EPFO, a person who has worked for 10 years in the company and paying regularly to the EPFO, then he is entitled for the pension. Now we have made the minimum pension of 1,000 rupees. The government has made 1,000 rupees from since September 2014. So a decent, at least 1,000 rupees a person gets, he can at least get his food. Then in addition to that, EPFO and ESIC, what they have done, they have gone for a, they have linked with the Shram Suvidha portal. On Shram Suvidha portal, we have a common registration. In addition to the common registration, the electronic return cum challan, ECR, what we call it. ECR is available for both, for the ESIC and EPFO through the Shram Suvidha portal. So companies can, the companies need not to go again and again for the ESIC portal or for the EPFO portal. They can go directly from Shram Suvidha portal and can file their returns, and they can get the common challan actually. Then in case, in a particular unorganized workers who where these bonded laborers are there, for them we are giving now more amount for their housing, minimum 1.5 lakh rupees. And in addition to that, we are conducting for the, particularly for the unorganized workers, to get into their social security, what we are coming within the social security code, how to provide the minimum wages plus at the same time the PF and the medical insurance after they get the age of 60 actually. So the social security code will be coming up that particularly we are focusing on unorganized workers. And then the most important is the job creation. As it is being told again and again, we all have to work to that side. When I was talking to Vice President Mr. Reddy, he was saying that he is also employing around 60,000 persons in all in retail sectors. I am really happy if we can provide a job and can give minimum wages to an individual, and particularly with all social security, nothing like that. Because what we are finding, the compliance, really it is a big question mark. So for that, naturally, if we can move to the formal, say, from informal to formal, then every person, every worker will be getting the social security because it will be tracked easily. And as on today, we are releasing this data about this job from the EPFO, from the ESIC, and if in the EPFO it is showing that average almost 6 lakh workers are adding every month as a new, we can say, new jobs, new UN numbers are being taken up. So that is the, means we can say they are coming to the formal sector. And it is quite good number. As on, means since we have started this Pradhan Mantri Rozgar Prohatsan Yojana, we have till now, the new job seekers have come almost 40 lakh, and we have spent 725 crore rupees we are giving to the employers who are giving these numbers and who are accounting for them. So it is quite good, and we expect that in this year we may be spending almost 4,000 crore rupees for the new jobs which will be created by the employers. I hope all of you know, as in this budget the government is now giving 12% of your 8.33% of your EPS, means employees pension, and plus in addition to that 3.67% for the PF. That 12% what the employer pays to for each worker now will be paid by the government. So for that, the government has already made a budget provision of 1,600 crore, which will be which we are now asking for enhancing this budget so that we can give to everybody whoever is being enrolled as a new employee by the employer in the EPFO actually. So that will go in a long way, and we all have to do a lot because we have a demographic dividend, and our GDP is growing with 7.4%. So we are quite hopeful things will be much, much better, and I can say we can become the superpower in the coming years, because the way in which we all are running, so we will be doing much better. Our each and every person will be, I think, will be with a smiling face, and Already a lot of investment is being done in the infrastructure. So definitely that will create lot of jobs. There will not be any problem. And now I conclude, I thank particularly the organizing committee for organizing this function. And I thank one and all. Thank you.